And we are back, episode 2. Let us continue down our merry path of time traveling and also not taking advantage of time traveling. I mean, fuck.
In the previous episode of Life is Strange.
Oh, please. Oh no, time traveling?
Whoa.
Yeah, we don't need to know that. We were there. We were all there. I mean, why would you start watching this playthrough from episode 2? That doesn't make any damn sense. I don't know that you need to tell me that at the beginning of every episode, but, I mean, go ahead, sure. Oh, no. I have to get up and shit. No, don't snooze. Seriously? I don't think that's appropriate. This is not snooze, this is waking up. Or not, I guess. Yeah. Doobity-dow. This is exactly the kind of music somebody would have as their actual alarm. Which is why it's weird that she would even have... not a hipster song as her alarm. Everybody else... her age and caliber does exactly that. Rewind time. Expanding time. The time machine. Is this like... weeks later? Or what's the deal here? You don't sleep with a blanket? It's like the Sherlock Holmes game type of shit. Where they're like, nah, instead of having her push a blanket off, we're just gonna have the blanket be at the bottom of the bed all the time. Yeah, I said get up. It's like October though, right? It was already snowing. Can't be that warm. Okay. Now if my
rewind will keep me clean. I still need a shower.
I was about to say, if I was for real,
Mrs.
I would go to the
Hoyer
bathroom
is still
first.
Out sick. I heard somebody say she has severe depression. Poor thing.
It must be English AP. So let's see. Monday was the day that I ended at Language of Photography. I don't end with Mr. Huda Fuzz until Thursday. What do we got here? You there, hippie? What about that fucked snow? What about your new power? Have you gone back in time and figured it out? Have you gone back and warmed about that joint? For reals, we need to talk. Or eat an ass buster breakfast at Two Whales. You there, Minix? I always for you. No emoji. Sad face. Meet me at the diner in 40. I'll be there. Do not be later. I'll know time is not on your side. After all, you did let Step Dork bust me. On my way. You are evil. 40 minutes or else. Okay, so that is the thing I need to do. Victoria says, by the way, thanks, but we're not friends. Cunt. 18. You told tall tales. Don't forget to water the plant we gave you, but don't drown it either. Well, I watered it yesterday. What, do I not water it every other day? What's the strategy here? I'm not going to drown it. A bottle of water. I could pour a whole bottle of water into that plant, leave it for a week, and it'd be fine. At least that is how my child brain works. Why does Victoria have my number? And also, why do I have Victoria's number?
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like, no time has passed. Now
Let's
I
see.
Have to wonder if any of these films are based on a true story.
I guess this is all time type shit. Go blah blah. Okay, she told me not to drown it, so I'm not gonna water it today. I'll wait until after I take a shower. Maybe not.
No smiling. Take your power seriously.
brutal. Way to take the analog camera thing and just bastardize it.
I can't keep my eyes open, but I know there's a scientific answer.
Oh, no, 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 no. I don't like that. That doesn't seem helpful at all. What do we got here?
I could rewind for days and read all of these books. Will I really find any insight into my power?
The real question is, will you get tired?
That's the only tourist picture up. That man, okay, Kristen and Fernando, are so drunk. Already watched that.
There's my hi-fi and my art books. I think I looked in here before.
It would be fun to get some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games.
Mystic enchantment cards. I don't know what that means. You know, I actually have a couple of card games that I made that are for sale on GameCrafter. One of them nobody in the world would want to play except for my very good friends, because I'm the one who designed it.
Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now.
And it's mostly just... Wait, how was I checking my texts, but I didn't have my cell phone on me? Alright, yeah, it's mostly just cards for, you know, it's like a magic card game, but it was with all my friends in it. Yeah. And then I have another card game that I designed called the Inverted Tarot, which is sort of like a super evil version of a tarot deck. Yeah, we already did that. I'm both reading my journal and using my phone without any of that stuff in here.
Gordon, seriously? Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like, now. Thanks, Sherry. Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon.
Oh.
I'm so on it. Consider it done.
You are a total noob. Poster, Brooke's room. Why doesn't Brooke and blah blah ever hook up? Maybe they should. Let's see.
Ow!
Nope. I apparently can't stop her from... Oh, I can't work.
Can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy. Wow, now that was close. Thank you, Max.
I don't understand. Did they not aim? She's gonna figure out my shit because I keep helping her out. So, there's the bathrooms. Presumably I can't use it. There's Juliet. This is the other dude. Wait, isn't this the skater kid? Love you. T for totally awesome. Oh, no. There's Taylor's room. There's the board. The X and Stella's room. I can't go into the bathroom yet, it looks like. So what? Oh, showers. Damn, you put your fucking hair into that thing before you got out of bed? Or did you leave it like that? Can you even get it out of there?
Hey, Kate.
Oh, don't talk to a person while she's brushing her teeth.
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday.
That was yesterday?
I needed that.
I went out and checked out all those books and DVDs and all that bullshit.
That guy
yesterday?
Doesn't everybody here?
Did she?
By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of The October Country?
Yes.
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far.
So, yeah, I read apparently all those books last night by rewinding time and then watching them and then rewinding time and reading
them. Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
Objective. Okay. Well, here's another hole to another universe. This is the same thing that was in Chloe's room. What the hell does this say? Oh, tampon dispenser. I thought it said tampon disaster. I was like, that's rough.
The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu.
fuck you.
Oh, man, that's... Nah, I like that. I don't know how I feel about... Yeah, close the door on me. That's... No, I don't need to be inside for this. No. No. Feel weird. I feel weird. I am an adult man. She is a teenage girl. Understandably, she's my avatar, and I'm supposed to just feel like I am her, but... Nope, I didn't need to see even a single second of it. Okay, what's wrong with you? Oh, what's you got drug me? Eyes.
School. That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Okay, you drug out.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
No. I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
No, don't preach it, sister.
Yeah, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate.
This game is too in-depth for me to believe that this girl is, like, genuinely a shithead all the time.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
Yeah, damn. You are an evil bitch. Only you're just an evil bitch. Okay. Yeah, so I keep muting my mic so that I can cough, which involves me putting it up and down. And maybe it makes a terrible fucking sound.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book. Water is almost as good as a cup of strong tea when I'm in sleepy mode.
What's it called? Katesvid.com. Somebody put up a domain just to mess with this chick. Probably this isn't going to last very long.
Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Good, because I like Kate. She's cool, just gotta let go. I don't know about that. Oh, Rachel is a whore. So, it would seem to me that somebody just genuinely didn't like Rachel. And that they owed her money and shit, she owed them money. Let's see. Presumably I still have my shower supplies, right? Hey, what's up, Brooke? You're
hey,
not
Brooke.
Busy.
Oh, hi, Max.
Show.
Did you see the freak snowfall yesterday?
Oh, snow.
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can.
Warren.
Did you talk to him yet?
Stop calling me Warren. My name isn't fucking Warren.
I will later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Wait, is Warren the X-Files kid? Yeah. Warren reminds me of the 5-second film where the fat, creepy dude with glasses says, "Why don't girls like me? I'm a nice guy." And then a girl runs up behind him and says, "Finish the sentence." And he says, "Who wants sex?" And then she's
that
like, that's
so
right.
That is so damn cute how much Dana is into this Halloween party.
Okay, which one's Dana? Dana's the cheerleader, and Juliet is the girl with the boyfriend. Oh no. Which one of you is boning?
What's happening, Dana?
Everything cool between you and Juliet?
Oh, yeah. Thanks again for releasing me from her captivity. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public.
Trevor?
So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max.
Trevor. So, which one is Trevor?
Are you coming to the party?
It's Trevor. Trevor's the skater kid. Party? Why not?
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max.
I don't After this, know if you'll be that's ready for how that raid. Script was supposed to be.
It does sound like fun.
Read.
Now I have to go contemplate my party future.
And you need to contracept your party future. Or is it you? Rollerblades.
Rollerblades. Oh, I wanted to be a derby girl, but I almost broke my feet just putting them on.
It must have been a bummer that they couldn't get the girl who played Juno to be this character.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max. Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
That's so not cool.
I didn't get wasted on camera and get busy with the Vortex Club.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
No way.
Do you believe everything you see? Like Zachary sexting Dana?
Touche.
I'm gonna go ahead and put this out there.
Thanks for finding out the truth.
Despite the fact that I'm obviously a scumbag.
Are you sure? I thought you'd be pissed.
Not
too long ago, they had the fappening.
Because I built up so much rage.
Which was, you know,
back in action.
Some guy who had hacked 100
and I won't watch Kate's video
hot celebrities' cell phones and put their sexy pictures and shit up on the internet.
Juliet.
Jennifer
sure.
Lawrence's
Talk
was like
later.
The most famous pair or whatever. Pair. No. You know what I'm trying to say. There was...
Dana takes her Blackwell spirit seriously.
Yeah, somebody put a bunch of shit up that was obviously meant for...
This is both sad and pathetic.
No. That was obviously meant for somebody's like boyfriend or whatever. And everybody fucking, it's all over everywhere. You know what I mean? And, you know, I mean, dudes fucking, I guess, jack off to that shit. But it kind of bums me out because really it's just one step removed from, you know, just saying, well, this is for her boyfriend, but it doesn't hurt her, so I'm going to take it too. It's like raping somebody a little bit. It's not an awesome thing to do. I think people do it because it feels like a victimless crime. But it's not a victimless crime. It's fucked up. Does that make sense? Just don't do it, okay? It's yeah.
I need to get dressed before I go there.
Why? I've been walking into girls' rooms. Alright, whatever. Yeah, I don't know. Just don't. That's all I'm trying to say. There are oh god damn it.
Ugh, no fucking way. This is not why I came to Blackwell. And I still have to clean all this crap up.
Who fucking
after I find Kate's book.
Who fucking did this?
Oh shit. Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe okay. told me not to go to the principal.
Well, it's too late now.
Man, this could almost be art if it wasn't so fucking sick and disturbed.
Hey, it's Ungian Andalou. That's pretty cool. I like that. Better put that away. I can't erase that or clean it up first. What's in
my
the desk?
My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there.
It was on the couch here.
No book here.
Of
course she just spilled soda on Kate's book.
Well, it's okay, because...
It's fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems.
Every goddamn other thing we can just rewind.
Be gone, foul soft drink. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine.
Okay. Yeah, why wouldn't I just rewind? Well, I guess I had to take a shower, right? Rewind and tell somebody, like, hey, will you go ahead and...
I am so not a rebel. I always like my bed to be neat and tidy. Thanks, Mom.
Yeah, I don't know. It doesn't make any damn sense. Art books, my photos, my sticky notes. Okay, yeah, she told me not to drown it, so I'm not going to water it today. Wait, I need to change.
Maybe yeah. I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time.
Another deer.
Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now. Kate? You in there?
Private number.
I'm here. Come in, Max.
No. She has a violin, a tablet.
Kate is all alone dealing with this video bullshit. I hope her mother doesn't disown her. Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week.
But she left it right there on the couch. Postcard.
Kate really has a doting father.
No, no, it's all Jesus-y. No wonder. This is why you don't go Jesus-y on your kids, man.
She's going to go through boxes. I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella.
Yeah. That's a poster. That's a velvet Jesus.
Hey, I'm trying to use my powers for good.
What you got
here?
That
is the cutest bunny ever. I bet Kate is a good mommy.
I'm just like, I know you're sad, but I'm taking pictures of your bunny. Your bunny, honey.
Ouch. She left out damnation.
No spirit... Wait, what does it say? No spirited devil could have prepared me for what you've done in the videotape. And Jezebel, you released your harlot image before God's A. Play for church. Blah, blah, blah. Auntie Marsh.
Good lord. This must be Kate's H.R. Geiger period.
That's pretty fucking sweet. See, I knew I liked Kate. She just needs to... stop being afraid of her family and shit.
Almost forgot what Kate looks like when she smiles.
It's because she... does the muchos drogas.
Maybe Kate has a split personality. Church girl by day, party monster by night.
A Bible.
Kate even makes notes in her Bible. My parents never once took me to church.
Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, I will give you rest.
I don't know what to believe now.
When justice is done, it brings joy to the righteous, but terror to the evildoers. Alright, and then she crossed that out because she was like, whoa, that's way too vengeful.
Damn, I gotta go to the All-American
New Testament
family.
Shit. Alright.
It's way too emo in here. Kate isn't that gloomy. Until poor Kate. She doesn't look good.
Alright, let's talk to Kate.
Hey, Kate.
I do like
I
Kate.
I got your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I had no choice.
I had no choice. David Madsen is an asshole.
You had the choice to not get involved. Nobody here seems to care about anybody.
Kate, I actually do care.
Yes, I do.
So, what's the
Kate,
story
Kate, you're
with
my
you
favorite.
David?
I decided
well,
it.
He's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Why?
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
Oh, no.
It doesn't sound like you. I can't see you partying with Victoria.
I didn't.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party?
Did you drink?
You don't have to tell
me
anything.
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
But you did. Somebody slipped you some shit.
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Oh, this doesn't bode well.
Nathan Prescott? Oh, shit.
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice.
Yes.
What next?
Nathan Prescott
is
a shit.
Driving for a long time.
He's
and
the
I
worst.
Woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck.
That's
all
good.
I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later.
Thanks
okay?
for all the gossip. Bye.
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag.
Book, bag.
So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
Why does David not like the Vortex Club?
I need
Club?
To find out
understand.
If Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
You should look for proof. I already went to the principal once and
if
it didn't
you
go very
that,
well.
They won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That
yeah,
seems impossible
you're good,
at this point.
Kate.
So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Yeah, no, I'm doing you a favor. Doing you a favor, you crazy bitch.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened. Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive.
Oh no, this is a... This says it all, somehow, but I don't know how. She put a
cloth
over
her mirror. Why did she cover up the
mirror?
She can't look at herself.
Oh, that's not good. Kate, take a shower, open the blinds, drink a glass of water. Have a breakfast. You'll feel better. What is all the meaning of this shit? Oh, yeah. No emoji. Oh, god damn it. It's all about I fucking just do all this shit in between, like, these sections. She's like, I don't do my journal hardly at all anymore. I need to do it more. So she just does it fucking 20 times all at once. Alright, so I'm late for something, right? Oh, what's in the can?
Samuel truly is a weirdo. But he is great at cleaning up.
Yeah. And let's not forget that Tilma the Haggard keeps the hall clean and always has. I'm talking about your Vasker. You guys, can you dig on that? Can you dig on Tilma the Haggard cleaning your Vasker? Hey, buddy, what's up with this bird?
The birds are flocking around Samuel.
Is it because you're special, like Radar?
Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
And birds whacking in the windows and shit.
For food. I can hear them whisper.
Yeah, what do they say?
What animals do you see in the forest?
I saw a squirrel, but it... Well, I did see a doe.
Don't laugh, but... I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me.
And I always wear
like
deer shirts. I think it thought that I was a deer.
That's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
I was trying to take a picture of it, but it didn't work.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like
you
that.
You are not allowed to refer to yourself in the third person, friend.
I so don't want
friend.
To get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
Samuel, you are one wacky-ass motherfucker. Football. Look at football. Food waste. Use food waste.
Kraken. Come on, squirrels. Time for your 15 minutes of fame.
Now wait.
I better not get near the bench, or the squirrel won't take the food.
You fucking bastard. Seriously? I obviously gotta take a picture of it. Yeah.
Yes! Another Pulitzer for the portfolio.
Yeah. Full exposure. Positive, negative, you know how it goes. I mean, we're talking about burning and dodging
I've
and shit.
I've never seen Samuel wearing shades. And what's with this other crap?
He found it. It's connected. Oh no.
I can see that Samuel's concerned, but does he need a poster? How did Samuel get photos of Rachel posing?
He got them from somebody. What's that all about?
Samuel really should keep this locked. It's a waiting accident. I definitely won't play with this thing again.
Why? The last time it went swimmingly, as I recall. Hey, Samuel. Here's a weird question, since I was rooting through your shit.
Hello again, Samuel.
Hello again yourself, Max.
Remember how I said I wasn't gonna talk about your fucking morning ritual?
Sorry to pry, Samuel, but... Why are there photos of Rachel Amber in your shed? I'm curious about her.
Sorry to pry, she says while prying. Now everybody wants to know about her.
Mm-hmm.
So did you know her?
Like I told the police. She was a good egg. And she gave me those photos.
Oh, you talked to the police?
Yeah,
Rachel
no,
wanted
it's
to
fine.
Be a model.
Listen.
Yeah.
The story wants me to think that this guy is murdery as fuck, which means this guy's definitely not murdery as fuck. It's probably the least dangerous guy in this whole fucking thing. Like my boy, creepy McFucking Fonenstein. Yeah, we already did this. We did that already. Alright, who is this sad sack of shit? Are you waiting for the... Rachel to owe you money, pay
Hi,
up,
Taylor.
Bitch.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
Let's not fight. Let's just hang out all damn night.
Victoria.
Let's just sing
Instead
it till the morning
talk,
light.
Let's
hang out
talk.
And play some video games. At
You're
the
funny.
Arcade, you know, we'll just
well,
hang
I'm
out.
I'm not doing anything at
yeah,
the moment.
And we're working on
so
rhymes.
Talk.
My metaphors are okay. How are yours?
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
Does she do that?
Why do you hang out with Victoria?
Maybe.
She's pretty mean to you and Courtney. And
maybe,
she's bossy too.
Maybe.
Look, you don't know her. I do.
You shouldn't go
and
around talking to people about
had.
Jesus. But...
I guess I've had
you know,
bossy best friends, too.
You're not allowed to fuck around with
better than having mean
motherfuckers
bossy parents.
Shit.
I would love it if my mom
That's
was
like
meaner bossy
command
instead of sick.
Or whatever.
But whatever. We've had our talk.
All right. I kind of didn't pay attention to that. I probably should have. I was too busy rapping. This is Nathan's father. This message attempts to slander blackmail my son. Lawyers, legal ramifications. You're not the first student at Blackwell to try this. Consider this a final polite warning. All right, dude. Whatever you say. You know where I sleep. All right. Whatever you say. Just stop calling me Warren.
Max,
my name isn't
check it out.
Fucking Warren.
Warren, what are you doing here?
Well, nothing.
Sniffing your panties.
Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
Yeah, rap.
By the way, thank you for stepping in. You were pretty badass.
Now
Warren.
Rap.
I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
No.
You're a real everyday hero.
Oh,
you stood up
God
to a bully and it was
You need to
awesome.
Rap.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
Yeah, let's keep shit
Just
to
a pirate I used to know.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star.
Yeah, and I'm glad that you
question.
Both have custom plates.
Why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
Yeah, I'll spread it with
I
shit on this
I busted him
kid.
In a bathroom yesterday with a gun. I'll give you the story later. Principal Wells is taking care of it now, I hope.
No.
You're fucking weak. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
Is he wearing a Schrodinger's cat shirt? Let's see here. Here's my take on this kid. He is desperate, which is usually a sign that, I mean, this is how girls see guys that do this, where they just throw themselves at the girl. The girl thinks, well, you wouldn't need to throw yourself completely into me unless you thought that you had nothing to offer, or very little. When probably the kid does have a lot to offer, but he's just not cool enough to handle it. Which means that while you might be able to have a good working relationship with him over time, because of the way he thinks of me now, which is in his own head, I don't know. He's going to react badly if I don't date him. Oh, fuck it, I told that bitch I was going to go with
yes,
her to the party.
That's exactly what I mean. I love those old
This kid at least
songs.
Took a fucking beating.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
Alright, yeah. I did say I was going to go to that party, but I couldn't say, hey buddy, we should go to that party together to him, so whatever. Doesn't matter. To go take the bus? Don't I live on campus? I was walking back and forth from school to my... Okay, I don't understand now what the hell is happening. What? Take the bus where? Yeah, take the bus from... The dormitory
to
here
cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate or Rachel.
I just had a thought. I'm just gonna keep it to myself because it's probably too good a thought, but we've seen people with their phones, etc., but there's only been so far one character who owned a video camera. So, yeah, I'll keep that shit to myself for now. Writing on the thing. Okay. Oh, she's listening to 07. I approve. The Garden is one of my favorite songs. Hello, how do you do? I do all right. I mean, you know, I'm pretty good. This is a big fucking bus for three kids. I think it's important cinematically that we see the entire fucking bus ride. Just give us an excuse to listen to this song all the way there. Oh, there's the lighthouse. It's out past John's Appliances and, you know, the Smut Hut. The Beaver Den. Okay, we just drove past this point. Did we not? Maybe not. Okay, here we are. School at the gas station. Jesus, those are expensive gas prices.
Don't try to take it from me.
Oh, that's right. I'm going to breakfast with this bitch.
I wouldn't dream of it.
I'm gonna be a millionaire. Hope nobody steals my lottery.
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same.
And this is important. This matters. Woman first.
Hi. You look lost.
Close. Do you know if the bus has come yet? The online schedule isn't working.
I just got off.
I just got off the school bus, but I'm sure the regular bus is coming too.
Oh, that's a relief.
The school bus takes me back and
forth. I can't be late for this job interview. I can't believe I have to take a bus all the way to Newport just to find a second job.
I can take a school bus to a diner? I don't understand.
Where are things good? I can't even afford to live here.
Well, good
luck. I am 18, I guess, right?
Thanks, I sure need it.
Maybe that's why there's so few kids. They just provide.
No time for chit-chat. I'm a millionaire. Yep. Got my lottery ticket right here.
Oh, let me sign this petition, too, real fast. Hey, buddy. Oh. Running late, grabbing a booth at the diner. Mom will feed you. Why is it? Oh, it's 8:40. Let's look at the flyers. What do we got here?
Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them.
I'm gonna read them right now. Oh, but just the cover. Yo, R.J. McCready. I like your workspace.
He looks like a photo of the classic arcade.
Good morning.
What's
looks
up,
like you're ready
G?
To catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal.
You holding?
Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
He looks like a Peaky Blinder.
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard, it has.
Oh, no.
Seems like a lifetime ago when
you're
I
not allowed to make sailor... weird piratey sailor puns. Your own boat?
You have your own boat?
I call her the Bali High. I've kept a hold of her in these lean days. Might be all the time we've got left.
I thought one of Arcadia Bay's main exports was fish.
Oh, the fish used to jump on to my boat. Until the press
thinks about the main,
the
main export of their, like, town.
The Prescotts have a lot of power.
They might rename the town Prescott Bay, if that tells you much.
They own my school.
Crooks gain respect when they put their names on schools and libraries. Let's not get downcast. I hear the fish calling for Bali High. Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell that way.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there.
You appear to be busy. I appear to be busy. We're both busy. Hey, friend. No, not my friend. Bacon and eggs, old-fashioned service. Here is man. Here is newspaper. Read newspaper.
Snow. Well, that's a good start to the story.
Man.
Excuse me.
Reads the newspaper for
Sir?
Me.
Can you believe this town? The world is on fire, and our big headline is snow. I can hardly wait for next week's big story. Clouds.
I like your jacket, friend. Let's not change the subject.
The snow was pretty odd. It was right in the middle of a warm, sunny day.
Oh, global warming bullshit. It's the Northwest. Snow happens.
I keep reading how Arcadia Bay is booming.
The paper can only talk about that or about missing girls.
Rachel Amber?
You mean Rachel Amber?
What did you read in that newspaper? Because I only got the headline and then one line. Alright. Fair enough. In we go. Need a babysitter?
Man, that smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again.
Pan Estates, huh?
Good lord. Talk about apocalyptic.
Prescott Development. Evil familial cabal.
Chloe and I loved the parade.
What's this all about? Unexpected snowfalls, huh? K-Bay 7.
K-Bay 7 News.
Oh, that is real weird. On a warm and sunny late piecing together, like, actual footage.
We'll be talking with Portland meteorologist.
I don't like that. Here's weird lady. Here's fisherman. We have dude, cop, gumball stand. Okay, that's a lot of looking. What I want is photographs. Unisex toilets.
That graffiti has been here forever.
Yeah. Rachel A. owes me
Gross.
A BJ. Hey, it's another fucking Twin Peaks reference. Damn shit, that is whack. Oh, look. And there's my spirit animal. I can't possibly not be associated with a doe. Sucks deck. Yeah.
Thank you, redneck poet.
I could dig that, man. Postcards. How's
it
going,
dude?
I
feel like shit. Too much beer, so spare me, please. Just let me suffer quietly.
I can't speak to this cop. He is a fucker.
I don't feel like talking right now. I gotta deliver a load of breakfast to my stomach.
There's no way that voice came out of that man.
Hello?
Pardon moi, but you're in my eyesight.
Isn't everything in here within eyesight?
I don't care for your tone. You sound like Joyce.
Hey!
How does Joyce sound?
Bossy and smartass. Like you.
Joyce rules.
Joyce rules. I want to be exactly like her when I grow up.
Looks like you're on your way. I've been coming to this dive for 3 years, and Joyce gives me shit like it's going out of style.
That's how she rolls.
I think
That's
giving people
I
shit
for every move.
Is yeah. going out of style.
I can't wait to see you flipping greasy bacon in a diner when you grow up. Exactly like Joyce. Now pardon me while I get back to my coffee.
Why don't you smoke yourself to death, motherfucker?
Drool. Want everything.
Man, remember when we were children? Young, high school children? And, you know, the only goddamn thing you could think about was eating like a dollar burger all day. It was like your big treat for the day. Now you just have to stop yourself from doing that shit.
And there she is. A lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce.
Hey,
it's
Joyce.
Nice to see
you. You look the same. You wore that
you
shit yesterday.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But I wish you'd been here to help save Chloe. She got busted yesterday smoking out. Again.
I know. Chloe told me that her stepfather hit her.
I am sorry that was your introduction to David. I hope you get to know him on your terms, not Chloe's. He's a good man. He just...
Yeah, I'm sure he is since you married him.
Yeah, I mean, my husband
Don't
went
be so harsh on Chloe. It's
went good to Iraq with him, and then he died,
I was hoping
and then
you could be a good influence
started dating
life
his,
now.
You know, squad mate, and then he came back
Promise.
Because he was, you know,
I know things
MIA
were hard for you
and
Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call.
Or is it the plot to Jarhead?
Now my folks are in Seattle, and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did, after William passed on. Chloe?
You didn't move forward with shit. Chloe, you're still a fucking waitress, man.
Anyway, I hope we see more of you.
You need to sell those gift baskets or whatever the fuck you do at home.
I am so sorry about William.
What happened to William?
I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Yeah, you know, Chloe has changed.
Chloe must have changed a lot during that time.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair.
That's one phase.
Now she's gotta rebel against her stepfather.
Also part of that one phase.
I mean,
why? What did Chloe tell you?
We already talked about this. Nothing.
Chloe doesn't have to tell me anything. I just know how David is at Blackwell.
You know what happened. David slapped Chloe. He fucked up. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell. All
right. Well, as long as we... Yeah. Let's drop the subject.
I get it, Joyce. I know Chloe still likes to stir things up.
But... Yeah, I am very much of the opinion that being a soldier doesn't qualify you to do a goddamn thing.
I guess it's
especially not slapping your stepdaughter in the face.
So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you
want? Oh, please, Jesus God, let me choose this. Yes. Fucking Belgian waffle, are you kidding me?
The last Belgian waffle I had was here when I was 13 years old. So, bring it on.
Now finish your coffee.
Max is just fucking going through Belgian waffles for the last 5 years.
One Belgian waffle for the hungry girl. Pronto.
Nerd graffiti. Warren must have been here.
I don't get it. What we got on the old menu?
The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
No, you fucking son of a bitch.
Nerd graffiti.
I wanted to read the damn menu.
Warren must have been here.
Ugh, I'm getting too trigger
the
happy.
Only thing that's changed on the menu read. Are the prices.
What did I miss out on here? The app. Well, yeah, I don't know. Nah. There's not enough like sweet breakfast shit on here. Like, where's fucking like? Where's like fucking strawberry pancakes and shit? This ain't nothing. You know what? Whatever, man. Fuck you. Drink that coffee.
Can I get some beer and
bacon? This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
No beer?
It looks like you had plenty. Stick with bacon.
That's a good point, man. Let me tell you something about... Oh, I can't get up. Oh, wait.
Oh, yes, black coffee. You will be mine.
Tough kid.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious.
Oh man, I'm
just... I wish
just...
I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then
totally got distracted. Can't remember what the fuck I was talking about before. Can't get up. Nerd graffiti. Black coffee.
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
Belgian waffle.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe...
I don't look much like a woman.
Speak of the devil.
Hey, what's up, Mom dude? Yeah, Dad dude.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
No, you're not. This is my treat. To you, for coming back to rescue my daughter.
Nobody needs to rescue me.
Unless you set your room on fire smoking out.
Oh god, here it comes. Didn't you and Sergeant Pepper already read me the riot act last night?
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
Aww.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town.
Chloe, why don't you have a septum piercing? That's the question. I tried to get up to change it, but it wouldn't let me.
Now that that's out of the way.
This is not in a diner jukebox. Putting that out there right now.
Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Tube of glitter.
You have a tube of glitter in there, right?
Nada. Wrong answer. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
So, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
We looked at all this shit. But I can't tell you.
I don't know.
Do you have some kind of power or not?
Oh, did I not look? Did I not look at it?
Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
You got panda keys, cigarettes. What is that? 80... 91 cents. And a warning ticket. Oh, yeah, all right.
So this is me telling you what.
Okay, Max.
You have cigarettes?
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
This I don't know, but I'm gonna say 7.
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Keys.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
It is a panda keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
You have... Well, you had 91 cents, according to my calculations. But it was fucking 3/4, a nickel, and 9 pennies. Which was 75, 80, well... Maybe it was just this.
86 cents.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34 a.m.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time. Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck. You have powers.
Yeah.
Take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
Hey, Mom. Max's powers.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
No 80s reference for you.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more.
You were born
something
in 1996.
Way cooler, so I will leave you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way.
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
And then Weird Girl goes to the bathroom.
That's the best song I've
this
heard
is
yet.
Sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Now I should rewind and tell Chloe everything that just happened.
Okay.
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so.
Trevor, Trucker drops his mug. No, it's Trevor drops his glass. Is that who that is? Trevor? No, Trevor.
The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
Alert on cop's radio when he leaves.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio and he quickly exits the diner.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Joyce stops
Justin and Trevor.
Okay, so I was supposed to say.
Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
Trucker plays a new
song.
The
jukebox goes crazy as the trucker tries to play a new song.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Well, I don't know, man. Now, the trucker is the guy in red, I thought. Is that guy supposed to be Trevor?
Oops.
Dude, did you right. break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
I think
dick.
Not,
slap
Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild.
Oh, okay. The cop didn't leave in a hurry. That was my problem.
This is a sad day in Maxville.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed.
Fuck that. I'm gonna get it all the way right.
I'm going.
Trucker drops his mug.
The trucker.
So, what happens next?
And his partner leaves.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
And Joyce stops them.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
And it must be this one right here. I certainly didn't watch a fucking fly land on it. Let's do this one.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max.
Oh, I guess I fucking...
Did you break another cup?
Oh, really?
Get to have...
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and eat my breakfast.
Is this the one that
hey,
I get for
partner?
Being perfectly accurate?
He's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Actually,
of course it's a toy.
Literally.
The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind
literally
time and blow. It's like it
don't
happened.
Have any responsibility to use this power.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Oh, would
too
you
much
look
excitement.
At that?
See what happens when we hook up again?
I can't use it over and over
again.
Let's
go to one of my secret lairs.
To blow my fucking blood vessels out.
You need a sidekick to guide you.
Bummer.
Okay, girl wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave.
Dude. It was at Belgian Waffle.
Chloe,
I know you're young and shit.
I wonder what kind of crazy shit she has in mind now.
But try harder. What's the Wall of Fame all about?
Forgot about the fishing Wall of Fame.
Hey, Andy Berry. This looks like fucking... Never mind, I can't remember that guy's name. It was a fun picture.
Whoa, Ken Kesey with Joyce? That's so perfect.
Why does that sound familiar to me?
I think I'm ready for thirds.
But you're only on your first.
My stomach.
Oh, they're both truckers, ahead. That's why.
Your stomach is stocking up for winter.
Hey, weird lady, I didn't talk to you before.
Hello there to you! Such a beautiful day, eh? Oh yeah, it's gonna be a super day. Enjoy your breakfast, eh?
She's a Canadian lady. Alright, what's this all about?
Oh man, I bet that's the same gum from when I was here last.
I'm not gonna speak to the cop. I trust
okay,
not the cop.
Let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and boo-doo-doo. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit. Let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school?
As a matter of fact,
I
yes.
See how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with too.
Yeah, you know what? Fuck you, all right? She's in a crisis.
What's up?
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay?
If I hang out with you, you're gonna get all bloody nosy and shit.
I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max.
Yeah.
If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now. Let's rock.
God, you're a picky bitch, ain't you? Oh, God, I just can't do nothing right.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument. I could rewind and not answer Kate.
You know what I could
do? It's not like I won't see her in class later.
I could rewind and fucking tell her, hey, I'm gonna get a call in a second and I have to take it. Because if I don't take it, bad things will happen, so don't be a fucking shithead about it. Just go outside. God damn. But, you know what? Whatever. Fucking give Chloe what she wants. It's all about Chloe today, I guess. Fucking Chloe.
Is this a race?
Keep up.
No, it's a murder scene.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
Every time I do it, I get a brain tumor, butterfly effect style.
David might be a douche, but you did steal his gun. Is everybody armed in Arcadia Bay now?
Only the ones who shouldn't be. Like Step Dildo. Until now.
I'm not in the revolution yet, Che.
You are the revolution, Max. So we should figure out how to best use and abuse your power with a test.
Okay. I'm into that.
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit.
Yeah, if it's beer, I agree.
Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles. Pretty please.
God, alright. Fuck, fine. Jesus, shit. There's one right there. No, it's a can. Oh, god damn it. Why is it gonna be all about Chloe? And why does this 18-year-old look like a 15-year-old? It's weird. Hey, look. Bottle. Hey, bottle. Take bottle. I'm gonna break it right here.
Stupid bottle.
It's okay. We will move thingy to thingy, therefore causing bottleneck to break somehow. Okay.
Hello, bottle number one. Four more to go.
Alright, I thought for a second she was just going to make me carry him one at a time back to her. Okay, so that's where I started from. Let's shift run a little bit. Look, it's a boat.
So sad to look at a grounded boat. I wonder who owned that and where they are now.
And if that's the boat that crashes in the lighthouse, that's what I'm really worried about. Look.
Beyond repair. Rest in peace.
It is a camera. Old camera.
I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine.
I fail to see what's important about that. Take this bottle, or are you going to drop it too?
Boom. Only three bottles left.
What else we got around here? Yeah, fucking anarchy.
Wow, sir. That looks exactly like the same dope.
Let's see. House calls, relativity. Texts are infinite, unlimited messaging. TARDIS, Newburgh is 60 miles, we should run 5. Hell yeah, we will in your new ride. Go Ape. That sucks. You suck. You are terrible.
From my tornado vision.
You know, I
That dough is the perfect photo op.
Is it?
This was an old school punk shirt.
Yes, sure. Where the fuck did Doe go? I thought it was over here. I got distracted by old school punk shirt. Oh, it's right there. It's all digital and shit. Yeah, hologram Doe. What is the picture? What's the picture all about? Does the picture show a doe, or does it show me on all fours and I'm naked? With, like, baked, drugged out eyes. Let's see. Logs, but no lady. I feel nothing for the stump, but I'm gonna sit down next to it anyways.
It's so quiet and primordial out here.
Primordial? You're surrounded by garbage.
I always feel like the forest is whispering to me.
That's post-mortial.
Like Arcadia Bay is trying to tell me something.
Yeah.
I just have to figure
out
the message.
Ancient Indian burial ground. Native wizards. Time wizards. Yikes. If I wasn't trying to record a not 2.5 hour, oh god, what the hell's happened? If I was going to try to record not a 2 hour episode of this exact thing, maybe I could sit by the tree and, you know, reflect on shit and shit. Is this a car wreck or a wrecked car?
I wonder what Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars.
Christ, that is bleak. Max, you need to fucking lighten up. Squirrel, squirrel. Squirrel, animal, spirit animal. Gregory, spirit animal, or fucking whatever and shit.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Where? What are you talking about? I don't want you to go anywhere you don't want to go. That's nice.
Thanks for the tip.
Bird, oh god. I was literally knocked off my feet by birds. This is quite the environment.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Whoa. Christ, man, I get it. It's the Oblivion Compromise, you know? Julie and Zachary again. There's no mofo here? Is that what it said? What's in this scary shackety shack?
This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here.
Okay, let's find out more about Rachel here.
That kind of hurts.
Chloe, Rachel. They're not even finished. Wouldn't worry so much about it.
I can't see Chloe playing with makeup.
Why not? She does her fucking hair.
They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachel.
So what, man? Ugh.
Now, what's up with this weird secret relationship?
You can tell me.
Sounds like Rachel was confused about it, maybe even ashamed. I wish she named names. I better not show this to Chloe or she will be seriously hurt.
You can tell how much I want to read this letter. I'm trying my best to give it to you. Maybe I just want to. I need to find one around so we never have to talk about it. I don't want you to hate me. I met somebody who's so different from the lame Vortex Club snobs. Tell you anything. Think he's gross. I swear he's wise and conventional. Kind of scary. Not in a bad boy way. It's just experience. It's some serious shit. Yes, I'm kind of obsessed. I won't blame you for freaking. Maybe I know you're right and this just has to be my secret. I'm sharing this with you, except I know you'll give me the stink eye and grill me for every stupid detail. If I even told you that last night we hooked up near campus. Bad. Elite plus 31. Alright, well. Mixtape.
Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape.
I don't know if that qualifies as a tape.
Ouch.
Yes, you. There's another beer bottle.
Three down, two more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this?
It was probably your friend Chloe.
So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared.
DJ Irish Bacon. I wonder who that could be. Oh, you are gonna fuck up if you're right there.
I don't want to intrude, but I was here.
Alright, fine.
Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel.
That will have consequences. You are in trouble. L.A., bitch! Which one is the one with the big ass, I wonder? Alright, I found, what, three bottles so far? I feel like I have fucking gone through a lot of this shit. There's a plank.
I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy.
There's a bottle.
I bet I could get on the boat from a higher location.
Oh, no.
Oh, gross. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground.
Mm-hmm. Didn't your good friend somebody-something tell you that she felt a prick in the side of her neck? Yeesh. Alright, well, what's this other thing that's up here? Sleep, perchance to dream. See, it was looking at something else. Chair. What am I going to do with that chair? I don't think I can even... I don't think I can even...
All this rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth?
Take the plank and move it over there, man. Because... How am I supposed to go all the way around all this bullshit? Shotgun shells?
Those shells look fresh.
Yep. The future is now.
I know there's a bonfire spot where people party around here.
People party. Move the plank.
Way heavier than I thought. Ugh.
Hey, listen, if Ellie from Left 4 Dead can do it, you can do it. Okay. If I take that bottle, is it gonna fucking explode? Whoops, butterfingers.
One more bottle to go.
But first, another fucking relax.
Dive, I see why Chloe hangs here. She's a steampunk.
What?
It actually feels like Chloe and I are kids again.
I want to talk to you people about steampunk for a second.
Despite all the chaos and bullshit,
the origins of steampunk comes from a William Gibson novel called Difference Engine.
So happy.
Originally, there was an inventor who came up with a very intricate machine that could do calculations. And the only reason that he didn't finish it, I can't remember the dude's name. The only reason he didn't finish it is because his mechanist kept fucking with him. I'm on your side. Anyways, so yeah, the premise of the Difference Engine is simply this. What if the information age came 100 years before we started using electricity? That's the premise. The whole premise. So, it's not what if steam powered everything or whatever. Alright, I cannot find the fifth bottle, Chloe. I think maybe what you need to do is start over.
I know there's a bonfire spot where people party around here.
Is that where my last bottle is supposed to be? Oh, look at the bus.
It's hard to believe that was once on the road, filled with dozens of students.
Or three. You know. Three students going to the diner. And nothing more. Bonfire. Where's the bonfire spot? Well, it's not that way. Little motes of dust, tiny blocked off areas. Sweet tires. The first car wreck where I began to consider whether or not Chloe thinks sadly of her father when she sees a car. I don't want to go there area.
I don't want to go that way.
Oh god damn it, you fucking bitch. How can this place not be filled with broken bottles? You know, I could see maybe not bottles, but syringes, shotgun shells. It's part of the problem that I...
Every car has its own tale and history.
It's part of the problem that I went around the outside, but I didn't go through the inside.
I know there's a bonfire spot where people party around here.
Yeah.
Aw, poor thing. They left you here all alone.
Oh, shit. I really hope that does cut that out, because I didn't even bother to check. So it's not around the inside of this thing either. Bonfire spot, huh? I thought this was the bonfire spot because there was the football and all that shit. was another bottle in here somewhere down at the bottom. God, this is so aggravating. Chloe, why don't you tell me more about that bonfire spot? Oh, I already looked at the gun shells. Ugh. No. I'm not coming back half-cocked. Just point me to the bonfire spot.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Brutal. Well, there appears to be a degree of smoke coming from around the corner of all this bullshit. Maybe that has something to do with it.
I know there's a bonfire spot.
Yeah.
I'm sure this is a popular party pit.
All right, just
I'm sure this is a popular party pit. Voila. Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
So I don't understand what fell down that made that whole thing collapse, but clearly a train jostled that shit. Right? Therefore, rewinding back past the train made it so that it did not happen. Ugh. Now where is that tramp? Oh, she's right here. Blending in.
That's my Chloe.
That's not your Chloe. That's a new Chloe.
Thanks, Max.
Your Chloe's dead.
Wait. One more for the road.
Can you...
You're serious about this.
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim. Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
A little to the right.
Come on, Max. Rewind and help Chloe aim.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir.
Duh.
That was so fucking cool. Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
A little up.
Now, Max, where do I aim?
Aim slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max.
Barrel, blue plank, rim.
Hello, what should I shoot? Fine, since you won't play, I'm gonna shoot this barrel. Yawn.
I was going to tell you to monitor, but...
Listen to those fat bullet beats! Give me something to shoot.
I bet you want to blow apart those old computer monitors.
Let's reboot them with a bullet. Old school.
So?
Lame.
Give me right. Something to
aim at that old blue plank.
Shoot
here.
The blue plank, I guess.
I hate old planks.
Yawn.
All right, shoot give me this something. Thing.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now?
Ricochet.
Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tex.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like never. So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
Let's see what happens when you shoot the gas tank.
Step back. Gas tank go boom. Car definitely down, but no bottle casualties.
All right,
dude,
so
I need a target.
The tire, I guess.
Tire.
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool.
Yeah. Fucking bump it, fist it, TIE fighter.
Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
Ugh, do not give. Oh, no.
I don't know.
Another bloody
Max,
nose.
Your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max!
I'm using all the salt, man. Just like the last game I played with the lighthouse. Oh, no. I went back, forward, up, down. Left, right, left, right. Hey, buddy. How are you feeling?
You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Yeah.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. Glad I feel normal again.
You need to eat.
I better go chat up Chloe.
More salt.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I suppose that was my last chance.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
Oh, boo-hoo. Max is afraid.
I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you.
Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
Oh, this was the dude that had the dog that I didn't see.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
No. Gun.
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Well, obviously, don't shoot.
Come on, girlie. Shoot me.
Well, see, this is different than what I had envisioned.
Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
I did not know about rewinding and shooting that guy.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, yeah. Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not
yeah.
cool.
No.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead.
Yeah, because killing a guy probably wouldn't have gone very well.
There are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
I don't understand why I don't just...
Frank took Chloe's gun because of me.
I don't know why I don't just take... the fucking...
Wowzer.
You
why
know,
did Frank
lottery
have
numbers
Rachel's
or whatever,
bracelet?
Rewind it once.
We need to talk about this later, but I better follow Chloe now.
Wait, where the fuck did she go? You said let's blow. This is your truck. Let's blow. God damn it, Chloe, you jerk off. This is the opposite of blowing. I already told myself a dozen times I don't want
to
come this way.
For a walk. We both need a timeout from here.
We're walking. See, I didn't know that. You didn't tell me that shit.
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go.
You said
right?
It was cool.
You can't keep getting mad at me. Especially for stupid shit.
I'm not mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down.
You're such a twat.
I just liked having that gun, man.
Well, I could rewind
now
and shoot the guy.
To protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk.
Alright. Yeah, let's take a break.
Feels
and
like
we'll
a
talk.
Different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
You want to get high?
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
No, we're not
we need
14
a new secret
anymore,
hangout.
Bitch.
At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
Seriously, Chloe, this is scary. What if Frank tries to track us down?
I'm sorry, but Frank
not
isn't
a shit
as
was given that day.
Us. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers. Obviously don't get my pot from you, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Is this your bad boy phase?
No, it's my trying to scrounge some quick cash so Rachel and I could get the hell out of here phase. Frank had quick cash, that's all.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy. Without him eyeballing us, okay?
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens. And it's like no time has passed.
Well, I could just go anywhere, and then if I get caught, I could just rewind to the point where there's nobody standing there. Why?
Why? I bet she would hate me.
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Because it's a metaphor for fate.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
Fuck Kerouac, man. Putting that out there.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
What the fuck are you doing?
Perfect.
It's not. No, oh, come on, man. It is really windy in my ears. Got my 7.1s on.
Max! Help! I'm stuck!
Hold on, Chloe.
My skate is stuck in this track.
What's that noise? The train. Oh, shit.
Look, a switching lever.
I can't even move it an inch. Awesome, it's not locked.
Come on, Max! Hurry!
I better find a tool to cut those wires.
A tool, huh?
Please, get me out of here! Get me out of here, Max! Max!
Shit, I can't budge it at all! Definitely use this bad boy. Score.
Okay, yeah, sorry, I'm not really narrating very fucking much here, because it's like, oh, fucking tits moment.
Total MacGyver. Again. Crazy. Now we're totally bonded for life. Damn. That was close.
I don't understand what I did that
Aren't
made anything different.
I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
If without them, you would have been dead already twice, so maybe forever is a bit short-sighted, don't you think?
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay.
Didn't you come up with that idea? I think you did.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
Oh, for fuck's sakes.
It means shit happens, right?
No, crazy shit happens. Because it can. And will.
I'm just a
geeky girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
Chloe
Price. How can
Price.
It be such a shitty week, and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again.
Yeah, high five, fist bump. Cool, I'm gonna go take some more pictures. I'm gonna go get high and steal another gun. Oh, best friends are fun. You know, you can try real hard and they can not try at all, and then you just somehow have to fucking compensate for all that. What do we got going on here? Enter the war, the exclamation mark. Trophy gazing.
I have a little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
Yo, what up, dickhead?
Oh, hello, Chris. I hope this isn't about the alleged gun incident.
Alleged? Nathan did have a gun. Have you talked to him yet?
Yes, he's deeply upset about this accusation. I don't blame him. Once I have all the facts, we'll talk. For the moment, focus on your schoolwork.
I can't focus when I'm scared.
Please don't say that. There's nothing to be scared of at Blackwell Academy.
Man, you are in the fucking pocket.
Is overseeing a new era of campus safety.
Oh no.
Mr. Madsen already treats everybody here like they're under surveillance.
Wait, wait. Do you see a pattern here, Max?
Probably not the same one you see.
It's very easy for you to instantly accuse people of doing terrible things. Nathan, Mr. Madsen, who's next? Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a meeting.
Meeting with who? You're just going to stand in the hallway. If I stood in the hallway, you would stand in the hallway, inevitably forever. Boards. What up,
Hello, Dick?
Sup, Max? It's weird to not see you without your camera.
Nobody.
I'm always taking
God
pictures
damn it.
With my eyes.
I bet.
As long I feel like very few people in high school looked like adult men.
I won't. That's what Victoria wanted.
Yeah. I noticed she kind of set up her own drama, even if it fucks her over. Weird.
She doesn't have to, though.
That's what I don't get at all. When she's hot, rich, talented, what more does she need?
Oh, anyway, no.
See you at the game Friday, Max.
She wants to fuck Mr. Jefferson, but he won't fuck her because bad things. Why the fuck would that matter?
These elite assholes throw a lot of big parties. Another chance for Nathan Prescott to dose somebody.
Seriously. Hello, climate change.
What up, bro? Yeah, sweep right into me. Oh, I'm sorry, are you working right here? Or... Yeah, what up?
If I was normal, I'd be super excited about going to a major shindig. Courtney will do anything for Victoria and the-
Hey, Courtney.
Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a Vortex Club soiree.
Really?
Oh, like you care.
I don't.
You're right. I don't. Making my guest list easier. Ciao.
End of the world party. Creepy guy. Principal douchebag.
Good thing I left my AK at home.
Oh, I already covered all this shit. No, not really.
Max, can we
God
talk?
Damn it.
Do you mind if we talk about what happened yesterday with Chloe?
What?
I don't think so. And you hit Chloe.
I'm sure she told you why. Did she mention she probably stole one of my guns?
No.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that.
What?
All you kids are.
Calm down.
So is Kate Marsh.
But you treat Kate pretty bad.
You step between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students.
Bullshit. Fuck you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore.
Calm down.
That's all, Max.
That was a conversation, I guess. Oh, Christ.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing Mads. Luke is always using the phone as a shield to avoid people.
That reminds me, I have to score some lead from Nathan.
Bully free, my locker. We did this, but I didn't do it. Or did I? Oh, I didn't do it when I rewound. Okay. I guess, whatever. What's up, Mrs. Grant?
Miss Grant is so cool and smart. She defines the word teacher.
What you got around here? Maybe an aquarium I could take a picture of?
I bet if I touch the glass, all these creepy sea critters will pop up. Or nothing will happen at all.
Yeah. Just neon tetra. Touch it again. Only this time, whisper magic. One of those fish just disappeared. Oh my god, they're disappearing fish. Alright, well, cool. You certainly did.
Howdy, Brooke.
Hi, Max.
Brooke.
Making your daily rounds?
How is your drone?
Miss Grant busted me flying it over the parking lot. She's all jacked up about surveillance bullshit. Like I was spying on Warren's new car.
Damn, Brooke, why don't you just squat on that rod?
I borrowed the one he has on you.
I hate to hit and run, but...
Don't let me get in your way. So long.
Dude, just... Yeah. I don't know. I guess. Oh, God. This looks like a puzzle. For later. That's fine.
Wonder why they don't use real skeletons.
So you can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine. Nobody does.
Okay, wait. Damn it. Jefferson, you fuck.
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
Yeah, nobody needs to talk to you about none of that shit.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography.
But then she would have been all like, meh.
I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this.
Yeah, man.
She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much.
God damn it.
She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yeah, I fucking talked to her.
Yes, I talked to her on the phone.
Talked to her all the time. Talked to her every chance I get. I would have talked to her just now if you hadn't fucking bitched her out of the goddamn hallway.
Next, Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I also don't want to become the next Rachel Amber.
But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
That was a private conversation. Not that I wouldn't tell you.
This is a serious accusation, Max.
Yeah,
so
man.
So you don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I'd like to believe that, Max. It just seems like there's a lot of drama around you this week.
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
But I... Damn it. I still have to talk to homeboy.
Uh-huh.
What up, Warren? Your chemistry stuff.
Bring me the brain, Igor. Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Concerned.
Hexal silver hammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Oh, no.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
We're gonna die. Let's do sodium.
I have a vision. Godium.
Godium? That's the worst pun I've ever heard. Yet Max has spoken.
I have heard worse
puns. Sodium it is.
And we die. Don't do... Jesus, don't do that.
Ugh. Damn. Zip.
All right, fine.
Hey, Warren.
Jesus, she writes in her fucking journal a lot.
Are you okay?
Maxwell, so...
Asking me?
Have daddy...
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but... Go... Potassium.
Potassium it shall be. This works?
Godium is a terrible pun, but go-tassium warrants no reference.
Weird science. Yes, I am a scientist. Fuck. Yes, I am a scientist. Fuck.
Alright. Good. You're a scientist. Fuck. You're a scientist. Fuck. You're still here making...
Listen, I do have a class I have to teach. I have to go.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'll do that.
Vague posts. Vague book.
Oh, I know. That makes sense.
All right, whatever you say.
Make me beautiful, Hayden. Vogue.
Tina, you are out of control. Turn left.
This is not okay.
Show me the love.
Not now, Max. I'm contemplating shit.
That's too good.
What's up, Daniel?
Waiting to draw Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on. I hope you liked the sketch I did of you yesterday.
Show enough.
Love. And it's my new avatar.
Excellent. I got tons of likes on FB. Ah, made you blush.
Shut up.
Someday your portrait may hang in the Daniel da Costa wing of the Louvre. We'll talk about it later.
Daniel da Costa? Daniel of the Coast? No, this is weird.
I'm kind of doing something now, Max.
You wore that shit yesterday too, you skank.
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress. Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal. Like I give a flying fuck.
Or she'll run to Mr. Jefferson, like he gives a shit.
Like anybody does. Max is such a little...
Shh, I think she can hear us.
Better be quiet, Victoria. We have a master snitch and liar here.
Did you think we were best friends forever or something?
Not at all, Victoria.
Max is such an attention whore.
Yeah.
You would know. Can I sit down now?
Oh, please do. Take a selfie of this moment.
Yeah, Max. So I won't forget you.
Man, that kid does not have enough facial hair to be threatening. You know what I'm saying? I mean, goddamn. No, you're gonna get fucked with. Kate Marsh is bouncing.
Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate?
Taking pictures of Kate.
Now this is so wrong and weird.
He's just trying to keep tabs on all the students to see where they were when they fucking vanished without a trace. Now what? Here comes my boy, Creepity Creepenstein.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Yeah, your eyes are puffy
Kate
from getting your ass kicked.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say, and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit
down.
We have a lot to cover today, and so little time
as usual.
Yeah,
what the fuck are you doing out here?
I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that.
It's cool that Mr. Jefferson published his own little book of photo tips.
I guess, is it?
We can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking
of, I guess Kate will miss class now. There are a few souls. I'm worried about her. In the
contest. I wonder if you just...
Max Caulfield, for example. Who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light
Jesus.
And dark.
Do you think I could just sit here and listen to him talk about photography
power.
For like
it's
a half an hour?
Yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast.
Yeah, this is my typical high school experience.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down at the girl's dorm! Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated.
What the fuck?
Dismissed.
Is this for real?
It slipped out.
I didn't think she was that messed up.
No, come on. This is not okay.
Something to help her.
What is that up there?
Not again. Not now.
Whoa.
I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again.
Yeah, I guess not, but... I was gonna recommend Wheelbarrow Full of Leaves. David, there's a pile of bullshit. What can you do? Go all the way in? I guess so. I'm gonna catch this bitch and pull her off, and everyone's gonna be like, damn, she was not in front.
Yes.
You better hold on to that fucking shit, man. Because if Kate dies, I am seriously not into the rest of this game. Well, fucking say something.
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me! Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to do this by myself? Max, seriously, don't come near me. I will jump. Okay. I'm right here. Kate, please. Oh, Max, I know you want to help me.
Yes.
I know that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters. You matter.
And she was smiling.
Not just to me. I do want to believe that. Kate! Your life is still yours, and we can get through this together.
You know,
let me.
I have had a few bouts of depression, and might I just recommend that if you're considering killing yourself, first at least, take out some credit cards and max them out on like some plane tickets around the world, and then go around the world and take a bunch of risks and just see.
Please trust me.
You know what I mean?
Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help?
What are you talking about?
You told me to do nothing.
I believe you, Kate. But it's dangerous for both of us if I get involved now.
I told you exactly what happened. Well, it's too late to help, Max. Too late.
Yes, I know I screwed up. I'm sorry, Kate. Please, you don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. Morty on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video.
God damn it, Kate. Don't you fucking dare. Nobody forgets. And that's true, but it doesn't matter.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Wearing a crucifix.
You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person, Max. Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Yeah.
Forever.
Don't.
Can we hug on
don't.
You?
Don't. Don't. Fucking don't.
No! Nobody cares about me!
What the
Nobody.
Hell? This is bullshit. That's horse shit. But your mother was blah blah blah.
Kate, I saw that card from your father. You can count on him. He clearly loves you without question.
I was going through your shit,
Dad,
by the way.
Dad doesn't care, even though I hurt him. He's the only one I know who believes in me.
See? You're not alone. And nobody down there wants to see you up here.
Yeah, because what
this
matters is what
the
they
end,
want.
Kate. There's no way God doesn't have big plans for you here.
Nice try, Max. But God put me on this roof.
Let's see. This one was the one about justice and punishment. This one was the one about the valley of being alright and shit.
Come to me, all of you who are weary and burdened,
boom.
And I will give you rest.
Matthew 11:28. I can't believe you quoted one of my favorite passages.
Like I said, I care about you. I know this passage means a lot to you.
And I'm not going to tell you right now about how I feel about the Bible and how it's bullshit. Go ahead. So that at the end of this episode, you can not be a problem.
I'm sorry. Sorry.
What are you talking about? You saved me from talking in class.
Yes. Save Kate Marsh. Suck it. Also, don't worry about how I teleported up there. Damn it.
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody, but I'm so proud of the way Blackwell pulled together to save a young girl's life. Of course, you're quite a hero for getting Kate to come down, Max.
I didn't do much.
She's modest. Like a real hero.
Yeah, real hero.
As principal of Blackwell
There's
Academy,
a lot of everyday
I take
hero
my
shit.
Duty seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always
mm-hmm.
be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility.
Not that that fucking matters.
Mr. Jefferson?
But okay.
I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer.